Hi everybody, this is Doc from Native Instruments, and in this video we're going to take you through your first steps with TRAKTOR PRO 3. This tutorial is perfect for you if you just installed TRAKTOR, downloaded the demo version and want a hands-on introduction. We're going to take a look on how to load and import your music and how to create nice transitions between two tracks with some easy tricks. I will also give you tips on how to use your TRAKTOR library and how to utilize your TRAKTOR effects. For the sake of this video, we won't be using any additional hardware, just my laptop and TRAKTOR Pro 3 software. So let's go ahead and launch TRAKTOR. The first thing we see is the demo splash screen. Here you can either activate TRAKTOR if you bought it or launch the demo. We'll launch demo mode. This will give us about 30 minutes to explore TRAKTOR time. Now we see the setup wizard. The setup wizard is for setting up TRAKTOR and any external gear we might want to use. Click next to move on. Because we won't be using any controllers or other devices, we can choose No here and then click Next. In the next step, we can choose our TRAKTOR layout and software setup. How many decks we need, what kind of decks, and what else we want to see. For now, we choose two track decks and a mixer and click the Next button. What we can see here is the overview of our setup. That looks good to me, so let's click on Finish. Right now, we're in TRAKTOR's default view. On the left-hand side, you can see deck A, and on the right-hand side, deck B. And in the middle, we have the mixer section. Up here, we've got the global section. We can see the master tempo, effect units, and also the mix and loop recorders. In the header, you have the master output level meter, and also you can find various status indicators, such as power status of your computer, the current CPU load, and whether or not TRAKTOR is receiving or sending MIDI signals or recording at that moment. And down here in TRAKTOR's browser, we have your track collection. The track collection includes all the music you've used, are using, or are planning to use in TRAKTOR. So how do you get your music into TRAKTOR? There's a few different ways, and TRAKTOR will always leave your files untouched. The track collection just serves as a very convenient interface for organizing everything. You can see the iTunes icon here. So if you're an iTunes user, you can browse your library through TRAKTOR. Since not everyone is using iTunes, I'll use my Finder or Windows Explorer to drag and drop music directly into TRAKTOR. I could just drop this track directly into deck and start playing it. This track then will automatically become a part of my TRAKTOR collection. Let me show you how to add multiple tracks at once. For this, I will create a playlist first, so I can later find the tracks quicker. Right-click on the playlist folder here in browser and choose Create Playlist. We will call this one My First Mix. Now you have created your first playlist, to load it up with music, just drag and drop a few tracks directly from your Finder or Windows Explorer into the playlist. To finally start playing some music, we just need to drag a track into deck A. When you load your track for the first time, TRAKTOR will analyze it. By analyzing it, TRAKTOR looks on how loud it is, what tempo it's in, and key it's in. And then we'll save all this information for later. Now you can see your track is loaded into deck A. This waveform doesn't just look colorful, it also shows you the beats and the events that are happening within your track. These white lines here represent the beat grid. It lets you sync two tracks with each other, matching their beats for seamless mixing. Now that track is loaded into a deck and has been analyzed, we can press play and hear some music. Every deck gives you an overview of the entire track here. You can click directly into the stripe overview to jump to another position within the track. If you want to jump to the beginning of the track, just click on this button. So next thing we're going to take a look at is loops and hotkeys. TRAKTOR's loop feature is one of my favorites. Once I set the loop, it will go on forever until I turn it off. That gives me time to create a nice mix and get really creative with some additional sounds and effects. Setting the loop is really easy. Just click on this button here and the loop will be set perfectly on beat. The numbers represent the amount of beats that are being looped, and you can use the arrows to cycle through different loop lengths. And with another click, you will change the loop size. Click the button again to turn the loop off. I will show you how to use it in the mix in just a moment, but before, let me show you another cool feature, hotkeys. To access them, we need to quickly change the layout of our deck. If you double-click on the edge of the deck, you can change its layout. Each double-click will cycle through the different deck layouts. Micro, small, essential, full. In our case, we use the advanced deck layout. You can now see an extra layer of controls below our track deck. In this layer, you can get access to controls for refining your beat grid, advanced move functions, and your hot cues. Hot cues are like bookmarks. They allow you to skip to a certain part of the track. You can use them to save loops and points to mix in or out of, as well as markers from which a track will always start when you load it. So if I activate my loop again and hit the 2 key on my keyboard, my current loop will be saved as a hot cue. If I press 2 again, the track will jump right to the beginning of the loop. Hotkeys work really well at the start of a break or a drop. You can also set them on a single drum hit. Once the loop is turned off, I can press any key from 2 to 5 to quickly create a hot cue at the current position. You might notice a blue flag that just appeared. This is a regular hot cue, and the green flag is the loop that we have saved as a hot cue earlier. There are even more kinds of hot cues in TRAKTOR, but we won't go into them right now. Let's stop this track for a moment and load up the second track. You can see that my track is being analyzed again. The beat grid automatically appears, and I can see the track's tempo up here and down here. Let's play track A and listen to how it sounds when I start playing track B shortly afterwards. They're both different tempos. That means if I play the second track, it runs slower than the first one. In the club, I'll be able to monitor this through my headphones. To mix the tracks, they need to be on the same tempo and we need the beats to overlap in sync. So to make a nice transition, we need to adjust this. The easiest way to do this in TRAKTOR is by hitting sync. Alternatively, you could of course do it the manual way and use the pitch fader and nudge the tracks into sync. Now that they are running really well together, we should have a look at the mixer section. And I'm going to turn down the volume of the track we want to mix in. With mixer EQ, you adjust the high, mid, and low frequencies of each track. You can use this for a really classic DJ technique for your transitions. Let's kill the low frequencies of the track that we want to bring in and adjust the mids and highs slightly to the left. Since we already synced both tracks, I will turn up the volume of the track B and then slightly bring in the frequencies of it, while taking out some frequencies of the track A. Okay, that transition was nice, but maybe a little bit dry. Let's spice things up a bit by using the effects section. TRAKTOR has more than 40 amazing effects available at your fingertips. We can combine those in many different ways to create unique sounding mixes. However, today we'll explore the new and exciting mixer effects of TRAKTOR PRO 3 that can be assigned within TRAKTOR's preferences. Just click on this little drop-down menu by the filter knob in TRAKTOR's mixer section. Here you can choose from 4 pre-selected effects to create another kind of transition just with one knob. Let's go for the barber pole and turn it on. When this knob is in the middle position, you won't hear any change in your sound. But as soon as you move it to the left or right, you can hear an effect coming in. Moving the knob to the left feels like you take out energy out of your track. Moving it to the right feels like you add to it. This comes really handy to create build-ups or breakdowns or make interesting transitions into new track. Let's set loop again in the deck B and do the transition back into the deck A using just the mixer effect. We just did exactly the same transition as before, but with a slightly different approach. There is no right or wrong when it comes to mixing. It's all about how it feels. So what if I want to change the style and tempo of my set? In this case, you can't really beat match and do the seamless transition like you just saw. So the track that is already playing has 89 BPM. And the one I want to bring in is at 128 BPM. So let's use Hotkeys, loops and a big reverb on the playing track for the transition. Cut out its volume and bring in the next track at its original tempo, right on time. Great, now you have learned how to load music into TRAKTOR, do nice and easy transition, and even how to cope with the change of tempo and musical styles in your mix. Thanks for watching, and if you would like to know more about TRAKTOR, go and visit our channel.